basic science. I even like calling it more like discovery science. And I love discovery science.
Basic science is discovery of new knowledge, new scientific fact. Could be a diagnostic, it could be a therapeutic, it could be a device, a product that, as a clinician, I would hope would benefit patients. But on the other hand, I don't see them as completely distinct.
I think I see them as less separable now. It's difficult to find kind of basic science research that will not, some point in the future, be useful to somebody else in some way.
The most visible science to the public is the applied science. And yet my laboratory, I don't do applied science. It's pure basic discovery. This is where the truly, landscape shifting ideas and capabilities come from. They come from out of the blue. Green fluorescent protein is a good example. This was identified from jellyfish. CRISPR for genome editing, this started from bacteria related to yogurt explorations. COVID vaccine, poking around with mRNA, seeing if that could be used as a way to deliver proteins.
If we ever reach the point where funding of research is based on a practical outcome exclusively, we're going to be in trouble, because most of the great breakthroughs come out of fundamental science.
I think this is something we often talk about, instilling in our children and in the next generation an inquisitive and curious mind. And fundamentally, that's what basic science is.
We're just exploring. We're following our noses, seeing where it leads us, making sure that we do good science, but doing what seems beautiful and what seems interesting. This is the best way to ensure that progress is made.